Hey everyone, and welcome back to my Stenohood. If you're new here, my name is Edna, and in this channel we talk about all things Steno, including tips for students, as well as my journey as a court reporting student. So if you're interested in content like this, please consider subscribing. I'm really excited to make this video today because I came up with 5 things that I wish I knew before I started court reporting school that would have helped me be way more prepared than I was. And now that I know these 5 things, I want to share them with anybody that's considering starting court reporting school. And I hope they really help you because I know that these would have helped me when I first started the program. So let's get started. So the first thing that I wish I knew before I started court reporting school is that I needed to be prepared to invest a lot of money into equipment. Now, compared to other schools or other majors, you probably only need a backpack, a pencil, a notebook, and maybe a laptop. But in court reporting school, you're going to need to invest in a lot of equipment. So the first thing you're going to need, which is pretty obvious, is your steno machine. Now, you can find a steno machine online for like a few $100. Or you can potentially rent one at your school if they have a program like that. But I would recommend to just try to find one before you even start school. And hopefully you can find a good deal and be prepared before you start school. So these are just things that I wish I knew before I started school that would have helped me tremendously. So the next thing is, now that you have a machine, you're also going to need something to carry it around. Now, I did make a video about the rolling suitcases and which one you should consider purchasing to roll around your steno machine. So I'll link that somewhere in this video. At some point, you're going to have to invest in a laptop. And this isn't at the beginning when you first start school, but just know that you're gonna have to bring a laptop to school at some point within the program. So that's another thing that you need to watch out for and be prepared to purchase if you don't have one already. The next thing is going to be a printer. So you need a portable printer because you're going to have to take your laptop and your printer to school so that you can transcribe your transcripts and then be able to print them out right away. So just know that you're going to have to invest in something like that too. So that's all part of the equipment that you're going to need for court reporting school. The next thing is going to be textbooks. Every school has a textbook that's going to teach you their particular theory. So just know that you're gonna have to invest in purchasing, you know, whatever books they tell you that you need to buy. The next thing is paper. So now that you have a steno machine, you're going to have to purchase paper. And you need 2 different kinds of paper. So you're going to need paper that goes in your machine, and then you're going to also need paper that you need to use in your printer. So just know that throughout the entire program, you're gonna have to invest in paper. And the last thing is just carry around a little notebook, like a little notepad, something to keep notes in, because what has helped me a lot is that a lot of times your professors are going to give you tips, and it's just in your benefit to write down these tips at the end of every class so that you can use this throughout your entire program. If you ever have a question, write it down in your little notebook. If your professor or teachers are giving you tips, make sure you write it down in your little notebook. If you're coming up with briefs as you go along or while you're in class, make sure you write it down so that you don't forget to practice those briefs. So it's helped me to write down any type of information that happens during class, to write it down in that little notebook. So that's essentially tip number 1, is know that you're gonna have to invest in all of this equipment. And I wish that I knew that before I started school so that I would have been a little bit more prepared, but I'm sharing this with you and I hope that it does help you before you start school. All right, so the second thing that I wish I knew before I started school is that you have to be 110% committed to this program. And I really wish I knew this before I started, because if you currently have a lot of obligations, responsibilities, if you're working a lot, whatever the case is, you're going to have to cut some of those down in order to start this program. Because if you start skipping school because you have to go to work or you have you have all these other obligations, then you're going to start falling behind in the program. And you don't want to fall behind because that's just going to make you feel bad, and you're going to see your classmates progressing and you're not going to be progressing, and it's not going to make you feel good. So before you even start the program, just know that you need to be 110% committed, because this program is very unforgiving. The less you practice and the less you go to school, then the further behind you become, and it's not going to be good for you. Or, you know, you just want to progress. And in order to do that, you need to know that you have to be 110% committed from day one. Yeah, you know, every once in a while you can miss class because things are going on, but for the 90% of the time, you need to be in class, because that's the only way to really get through the program. And I wish I knew this before I started, because I used to think like, oh, I'm just gonna go to the important classes, or oh, I'll just go to class one day, or I'll do lab whenever I feel like it, or I'll practice whenever I want. And that happened to me, and then I wasn't progressing, and then I was wondering why. And that's because I didn't know that this program, you need to be 110% committed. But now you know. So before you even start school, make sure you cut down some of those obligations that you have, and know that you're gonna have to be committed to this program. So that's tip number two. Okay, so tip number three, or the third thing that I wish I knew before I started school that would have helped me tremendously, is that you're going to have to sacrifice your time. So if you currently have a routine of like staying up late to watch your favorite show on TV, or going out with your friends or family, or whatever the case is, you're gonna have to sacrifice those things, because court reporting school is gonna take up that time. So just know that you're gonna have to sacrifice this for the time being until you finish school. And the sacrifice is going to be worth it. So for example, if you're used to watching a 2-hour show on TV every night, now you have to replace that with practicing for court reporting school. So 1 or 2 hours, and you're gonna replace whatever you were doing before. So know that before you even start school that you're gonna have to manage your time a lot better by sacrificing a lot of the things that you enjoy doing or that you would consume most of your time with. Now that's gonna be replaced with practicing for steno or doing your homework, etc. And that's something that I wish I knew before I started, but I really hope that helps you and that you're more prepared than I was when I started the program, so that you're aware that that's what you're gonna have to do. Okay, so tip number four is pretty simple. It's essentially having passion for court reporting, finding that perseverance within you and that motivation. And I did make another video that talks about why you need those three things. And this is definitely something that I wish I knew before I started the program, because this is why a lot of students are dropping out, because they don't realize how difficult court reporting is. But if you have passion for this program, you will make it. And if you're able to persevere regardless of the situation, you will make it. And motivation, you are going to have to find that motivation within you to get through the program. So that's my tip number four. And the last tip number five, is find a classmate or a friend that's in the program that you can get through the program with. So I really wish I knew this before I started school, because when I first started, I was like, oh, I could do this by myself. You know, I don't need anybody to motivate me. Like, I'm grown, I could do this. Like, I could do this. But now that I've switched over to the day program, I've realized how important it is to find that one person in this whole school, at least one person. If you can find more than one person, then more power to you. But if you can at least find one person that you share the same goals, that you share the same work ethic, because that way you guys can help each other get motivated and get through the program, or vent to each other, or share ideas with each other, and you know, try to get through the program with somebody that's going through something with you at the same time. And this is so crucial, and it's gonna make your experience in court reporting school that much better, at least in my opinion. Having somebody there to hold each other accountable, or you know, if somebody isn't in class one day, the other person can, you know, make sure they're okay and let them know like, hey, somebody at school cares about you and you can do this and we're here in it together. And that way your experience in school is gonna be that much better. So that was tip number 5. I really hope you liked this video. Please keep the conversation going in the comments below. Ask me whatever you like. I'll try to answer it as best as I can. And let me know if you're currently in school, if you have any other tips for students that are considering going to court reporting school, please leave them in the comments. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.